We join you from Memorial Field here in Charlottetown at Victoria Park for CCBA Wild Card Series action between the Holland Hurricanes and the Acadia Axemen. Up first to bat here, Matt Gendron, pitching for the Hurricanes, number 22, Spencer Horn, in game one of two here today at Memorial Field. If the Hurricanes win, they will advance on to the Nationals in Fredericton. And if UNB wins, or if Acadia wins, sorry, they will head to Montreal to beat Concordia this weekend to go to the Nationals. As we're underway here at Memorial Field for a beautiful day of baseball. Strike two for Spencer Horn on number seven, the left fielder for the Acadia Axemen. Leading off the game, Matt Gendron. Two and two the count. The Hurricanes losing to the St. Mary's Huskies this past week. 2-1. Now they will need to win this wild card series to earn a spot in the Nationals at UNB in Fredericton. Gendron calls time. Count 2-2 here in the top of the first. And that'll be strikeout to start the game for Spencer Horn.
Now batting for the Axemen, first baseman number 8, Mark Matthias.
The first baseman, Mark Matthias, up next for the Acadia Axemen with one away here in the top of the first. Strike one for Spencer Horn on Matthias with one away. That'll be a blooper into J.J. Oram, the shortstop, and he will go out at first. Two away for Spencer Horn and the Hurricanes here, top of the first.
Second baseman number 9, Ted Higa.
A blooper over the head of Spencer Horn, played perfectly by the shortstop J.J. Oram. And Matthias out at first. Ted Higa up for the Axemen, the second baseman, number 9. Higa batting 143 in the two games they've played here in the playoffs. That'll be fouled back into the fence here at Memorial Field. Two away here in the top of the first. Another foul back into the fence by Higa. 0-2 the count, two away. Spencer Horn looking to end this first inning quick. A little high, ball one. Spencer Horn, 1-2 the count, 2-2 the count. That'll be fouled into the grandstands here at Memorial Field along the third baseline. 7 innings of baseball ahead here in game one. Game two will follow at 3:30, around then. That one's high. We got a full count between Horn and Haiga here as Horn tries to end the inning and Haiga looks to extend it for the Axemen. Full count for Horn. Haiga will call time as Spencer Horn takes a little too long here with the count full and two away in the first inning. That one's foul way back into the parking lot here at Memorial Field. Haiga stays alive, keeping the inning going. Full count as Haiga battling it out with Spencer Horn. And that one will be fouled back just over the catcher's head. Staying alive with two away in the top of the first. That one hit into center field. Second baseman back tracks, that's Jonathan Arsenault, and ends the inning for Spencer Horn. Three up, three down.
For the Axemen in the top of the first, they scored no runs on no hits. There were no hurricane errors and no runners left on base.
So Spencer Horn gets out of the top of the first. Three up, three down. We'll head to the bottom of the first as Axemen pitcher David Pilott will come to the mound against this Hurricanes team. David Pilott in one game so far this playoffs, three innings played. He's allowed 7 hits, 6 runs in the loss for the Axemen. J.J. Orem will lead off for the Hurricanes. Orem is batting 0 as he's only been in at 1 at bat. No, I'm sorry, I'm looking at Glenn Harvey. Orem 12 at bats, batting 364 for the playoffs in the 3 games they played against the St. Mary's Huskies. Orem, Taylor Larkin, and Grant Grady will be due up here in the first. Best of 3 series. If one of these teams cannot win it today, they will play tomorrow in Acadia, game 3, to decide if the Hurricanes will go to the Nationals. If Acadia wins, they will go to Montreal and try and win their berth into the Nationals.
Oh, he must be on my computer. That's the website version of Game Changer. It shows who's in the field.
J.J. Orem.
On the first inning for your Holland Hurricanes. The shortstop, number 11, J. Orem.
Orem and David Pilott, the pitcher for the Axemen today. Mark McPhee, the catcher for the Axemen. You can connect with the Hurricanes baseball through their Twitter at CanesMBaseball. Send a tweet if you're watching today in the stream through Bell for CCBA baseball action, the wild card series between the Axemen and the Hurricanes. Strike one by Pilott on Orem. Start the bottom of the first in a 0-0 baseball game. Game one of 2 today. That one will be fouled into the parking lot. Another foul by Orem into the grandstands here. Into the field at Memorial Field in Victoria Park. Jay Orem will get over the head of the third baseman, but into the glove of left fielder Mac Gendron, and one away for Pilat in the Axemen.
Center fielder number 16, Taylor Larkin.
Over the head of Axemen third baseman Will Robinson, but the left fielder was right there, Matt Gendron, and one away for the Axemen here in the bottom of the first. Taylor Larkin up, the center fielder for the Hurricanes. That'll be ball one to start. One away for the Axemen. Hit to the second baseman. He will control that and send it to first baseman Mark Matthias. Two away for the Axemen here in the bottom of the first.
Designated hitter number two, Grant Grady.
Hurricanes designated hitter number two, Grant Grady. Up a bat and 11 at-bats this playoffs. He's batted 545. And that's why he is the designated hitter today for the Hurricanes. He bats third here in the first inning. David Pilat for the Axemen. The pitch to Grady, and that'll be a ball two for Grady. That one will be hit over the third baseman's head and into left field. And Grant Grady will get a stand-up double on that one with two away here in the first inning, as that one was hit hard into left field. Matt Gendron could not reach it. And Grady with a double. And the first hit of the game.
The catcher, number five, Logan Gallant.
And that'll extend this bottom of the first for the Hurricanes as Logan Gallant, the catcher for the Hurricanes, comes to the plate. Logan Gallant batting 125 and 8 at-bats in the playoffs against the Huskies in the three games. With Grady on second with two away. Logan Gallant looking to extend the bottom of the first here for the Hurricanes against Pilat and the Axemen. He'll take ball one. Pitch, that one will be low. Ball two for Logan Gallant. In game one of this doubleheader for today, one of these teams will look to finish the series today, if not tomorrow, in Acadia for game three. As the Hurricanes look to go back to Nationals, they won the league last year and were there. And that'll be a strike one, 2-1 the count. Grant Grady had a huge lead off second. Two-way for Pilat and the Axemen here in the bottom of the first. Three up, three down for Spencer Horn and the Hurricanes in the top of the first. Grant Grady's going to third. He fouls it back. Grady will return to second. 2-2 the count with two away for Pilat and the Axemen. As Logan Gallant stands in here, the catcher for the Hurricanes. be out looking to. And the first, 2-2 the count. The pitch from Pilat. And that one will be low and will full count here for Logan Gallant. Two-way. Looking to extend the inning with the man on second for the Hurricanes. Full count. Two-way. And he'll walk the fourth, batting number four of the inning. Man on first and second with two-way for the first baseman, Kyle Donahoe. And the Hurricanes comes to the plate. Donahoe batting .222 in the three games, nine at-bats for the Hurricanes. Man on first and second, two-way. Pilat looking to end the inning and end this first inning. And the Axemen will be back at bat at the top of the second. Donahue gets that into the gap. It'll roll into center field. And Grant Grady comes around third. He'll score. There'll be men on first and third for the Hurricanes with two away. A 1-0 game here in the bottom of the first for the Hurricanes. Grant Grady will score. And Kyle Donahue with an RBI single. A 1-0 Hurricanes lead. Now Dylan McQuaid, the third baseman for the Hurricanes, comes to the plate. Two-way. Pilat having trouble finishing the first inning here against this Hurricane team. And Kyle Donahue goes, steals second. He's safe. And Logan Gallant will score as the catcher threw to second. Donahue was on, was there in time and allowed Logan Gallant to score. So it's a 2-0 Hurricanes lead here with two away in the first inning. So Kyle Donahue with a stolen base. Grant Grady and Logan Gallant with the runs in this bottom of the first. All coming with two-way for the Hurricanes to make it 2-0. Two-way, Dylan McQuaid at the plate. That one will be ball one. 1-2 the count for McQuaid. Pilat having trouble ending this first inning with a strong Hurricanes batting order. That one will be high. 2-2 the count. Two away. Runner on second, Kyle Donahue stole second, allowing Logan Gallant to score. It's 2-0. Now it'll be high. Full count, two away. Pilat desperately needs to end this inning for the Axemen. Fouled over the Axemen dugout and into the trees here at Memorial Field, Victoria Park, Charlottetown, PEI.
That's a nice breeze today.
Full count, two outs, Dylan McQuaid hits that way in the air. Lost in the sun for me, but the second baseman for the Axemen, Ted Heiga, finally ends the inning as Dylan McQuaid will fly out to second base.
In the bottom of the first, the Hurricanes scored two runs on two hits. There were no Acadia errors and one runner left on base. Through one complete, Holland College, two Acadia, no score.
So we head to the top of the second inning. Here in CCBA baseball action from Charlottetown in game one of this wild card series between the Hurricanes and the Axemen. Spencer Horn returns to the mound for the Hurricanes after a 3-up, 3-down first inning. due up for the Axemen. Mark McPhee, the catcher. Third baseman, Will Robinson. And shortstop, Tristan Reed. Hurricanes in the first inning. Six batters. Seen Pilat, Grady, and Logan Glantz score. Donahue at an RBI single. And it's 2-0 for the Hurricanes to start game one of this doubleheader. Mark McPhee in 2 playoff games, 6 at bats, batting 167 with 1 hit.
The catcher, number 10, Mark McPhee.
Beautiful day for fall baseball here in Charlottetown. And we'll have 2 games for you. Two and all the count to start the second inning. Three and all. Start the second inning. Spencer Horn and Mark McPhee, the catcher, up for the Axemen. 2-0 Hurricanes lead after the first inning. And that one will be fouled way over the dugout. Into the trees here in Charlottetown.
You can text Cass if you want.
3-1 the count for a Horn and McPhee. That one will be fouled back over our heads here in the booth. And Mark McPhee stays alive. If you are listening, send a tweet to Canes M Baseball on Twitter. Let them know where you're listening from. As Mark McPhee will take a walk to lead off this second inning off Spencer Horn. And Will Robinson, the third baseman, will come to the plate with no outs and a man on first. As Mark McPhee takes that walk, the catcher. Will Robinson, 6 at-bats, batting 167 for the Axemen. Ball one. Brett Hicken, Jonathan Arsenal, Dominic Ryan, the bottom of the lineup for the Hurricanes will be due up in the bottom of the second. His Horn gets a foul ball from Will Robinson. 1-1 the count, no outs, man on first. After Horn walked Mark McPhee to start the second inning. That one will be low and inside, 2-1 the count with no outs for Robinson. Hit to the third baseman, Dylan McQuay looking for the double play over the glove of Jonathan Arsenault and into center field, and we'll have runners on first and third as McQuay went for the double play ball at second to Jonathan Arsenault. It bounced over his glove, allowing Mark McPhee to advance to third. Will Robinson We'll get to first on that. Runners on the corner, no outs for the Axemen here in the second inning. Spencer Horn looking to get at least one out here and go from there on against these Axemen. Pitch fouled way over our heads into the parking lot. 0-1. On Tristan Reed, the shortstop for the Axemen, who had 7 at-bats, batting 143, with 1 hit in the playoffs for the Axemen. Fouled back in the dirt for Reed. 0-2. Runners on the corner. As the Hurricanes could have had 2 outs, at least 1. But a misplayed ball between Dylan McQuaid and Jonathan Arsenault. That one will be over the first baseman's head into right field. Dominic Ryan hold on to that one as a single for Tristan Reed. And their Axemen will score 1. Men still on the corners as Mark McPhee scores on an RBI single from Tristan Reed, and it's 1-0, or 2-1, I'm sorry. And still no outs for Spencer Horn and the Hurricanes. Now up at bat, Sam Gallant, the right fielder for the Axemen. Only 3 at-bats in the playoffs so far. Spencer Horn. Runners on the corner, no outs. This is batter number 7. Sam Gallant, the right fielder, steps to the plate. Ball 1. Will Robinson standing on third. Tristan Reed on first after his RBI single, cutting the lead to 2-1 for the Axemen. Strike 1. Still no outs for Horn. And the Hurricanes are in the top of the second. It's a 2-1 baseball game as you'll check up at first to Kyle Donahue, the first baseman for the Hurricanes. Tristan Reed, the shortstop, standing there. He'll check up. 1-1 the count. Sam Gallant, the right fielder for the Axemen. And he'll call time. His Horn checks the runners on the corner. Checks up at first again. Gets away from Donahue, but keeping Tristan Reed close to first base. Will Robinson standing on third. No outs. Spencer Horn and the Hurricanes here in the second inning. That one will be fouled into the dirt. 1-2 the count now. Another check up at first on Tristan Reed. And again. Committed to getting Reed at first, but they cannot get the first. And again. Keeping Reed very close to that first base. With Sam Gallant at the plate at 1-2 the count, no outs. Bottom, top of the second. And Gallant will call second. Long at bat here. As Horn and the Hurricanes have their hands full, keeping these runners on the corner. Checking up. Safe again as he dives into first. That was fouled by Sam Gallant. Still 1-2 the count. No outs here in the top of the second in a 2-1 baseball game. Sam Gallant, the right fielder, batting seventh. Percy Clark, designated hitter for the Axemen, two up next, and that'll be out number one for Horn and the Hurricanes, and a strikeout of Sam Gallant.
Designated hitter number 33, Percy Clark.
That'll be his second strikeout of the day. He struck out Matt Gendron in the first, and now strikeout on Gallant. One away, Percy Clark, the designated hitter, up with one away. Men still in the corners in a 2-1 baseball game. Strike one on Percy Clark. Percy Clark only seeing two at-bats so far this playoffs. He had to get a hit. And the runner goes to second baseman, and he'll be safe at second as Tristan Reed steals second. Logan Gallant, a little bit of hesitation as he makes sure the runner on third, Will Robinson, wasn't coming home. And by the time he got it to Jonathan Arsenault, Tristan Reed was safe at second. Runners on second and third now, one away. Percy Clark at the plate, the designated hitter. As the infield closes in for the Hurricanes. One away, runners on second and third. Percy Clark, the designated hitter. That one's inside. And that one, another strikeout. As Percy Clark watches that one go by, strikeout number three for Spencer Horn.
Center fielder number 18, Wes Harding.
As we're into the bottom of the lineup, the number nine batter, center fielder Wes Harding, with two away. Runners on second and third. Spencer Horn looking to get out of this inning with the lead. Strike one to start. On Harding, three strikeouts for Horn so far here in the top of the second. Pitch by Horn, fouled. Back into the parking lot by Harding. Two away. Katie able to score one run here in the top of the second. Spencer Horn looks to keep it at that, keep this Hurricanes lead 2-1. That would be a ball. Ball one. One and two the count for Horn. That one's fouled. 1 and 2. As Wes Harding stands in, the number 9 hitter for the Axemen. Top of the lineup, Matt Gendron on deck. They look to keep the inning alive for the Axemen. Harding calls time. Ooh, that one's way inside, 2-2. Strikeout to end the second inning for Spencer Horn. 3 strikeouts in a row.
In the top of the second, the Axemen scored 1 run on 1 hit. There was 1 hurricane error. 2 runners left on base through 1.5 complete. Hurricanes 2, Axemen 1.
Four strikeouts so far for Spencer Horn. They head to the bottom of the second inning. Hurricanes baseball, CCBA wild card series here at Memorial Field, Victoria Park, Charlottetown, PEI. We're going to head to the bottom of the second. David Pilott returns to the mound for the Axemen. The Hurricanes had 2 hits on 2 runs in the first. Darcy Cudmore here with you in the booth at Memorial Field. It's a 2-1 baseball game as the Axemen pressed in the top of the second. Horn with 3 strikeouts in a row on Sam Gallant, Percy Clark, and Wes Harding, the bottom of the lineup. And the Axemen leave runners stranded on second and third. And we head to the bottom of the second. We're due up for the Hurricanes is batter number 7. Brett Hicken, the left fielder, Jonathan Arsenault, second baseman, and the right fielder, Dominic Ryan.
Leading off for the Hurricanes, the left fielder, number 10, Brett Hicken.
Brett Hicken batting 167 here in the playoffs so far, 6 at-bats against the Huskies, as the Huskies won that series 2-1 and will advance to the Nationals. They're in the Atlanta Conference Championship Series this weekend against UNB. And the Hurricanes, first place in the regular season, getting eliminated by the fourth place Huskies. And now they look to go to the Nationals through wild card berth. As Brett Hicken gets the first out of the inning for David Pilott and the Axemen, Jonathan Arsenault up to bat now for the Hurricanes. His first at bat of the game in this bottom of the Hurricanes lineup. Batter number 8 and 9, Dominic Ryan, due up next. Strike 1-1 the count on Jonathan Arsenault. Ball 2-1 the count with 1 out so far for Pilott. That one's inside. 3-1 will be the count for Jonathan Arsenault here in the bottom of the second inning. Oof. Inside and high to Jonathan Arsenault, and David Palau will walk Arsenault.
Right fielder number 23, Dominic Ryan.
As Dominic Ryan will come to bat for the Hurricanes. Dominic Ryan batting 143, seven at bats in these playoffs. That's Pilat's first walk of the day to Jonathan Arsenault. He checks up with his first baseman, Mark Matthias, on Jonathan Arsenault. Dominic Ryan fouls that into the dirt. Home plate. Jonathan was headed to second. He'll return to first. Pitch fouled into the trees over the Axemen dugout. For Dominic Ryan, the right fielder, number 23 for the Hurricanes. I want to be inside. For Ryan. One away here in the bottom of the second. Dominic Ryan standing in at the plate against David Palat of the Axemen. In game one of two for the day, this doubleheader. That one will get hit into center field. Drop in front of the center fielder, Wes Harding. And a single for Dominic Ryan. And it'll advance the runner, Jonathan Arsenault, to second.
Shortstop, number 11.
And we got runners on first and second here in the second inning with only one out. As we'll head to the top of the lineup for the Hurricanes, Jay Oram, the shortstop. 0-1 so far on the day. One away for Palat and the Axemen. Palat steps off the mound, checking on the runners, Arsenault and Ryan. Pitch to Jay Oram. Jay Oram will bunt, and that'll roll foul. As it crosses the line along the third baseline. Another bunt, and that one will get to the pitcher. Palat will try and play it to first baseman, but it won't be in time. Jay Oram will reach first and load the bases here with a bunt to the pitcher, Palat, who could not get it there in time. Perfectly placed bunt by Oram, and he loads the bases. Arsenault, Dominic Ryan, and now Jay Oram on base for the Hurricanes. One away for Palat and the Axemen. The Hurricanes look to open this game up. Now is Taylor Larkin, the center fielder for the Hurricanes, comes to the plate. Eleven at-bats for Larkin, batting 545 in the playoffs against the Huskies. And he'll foul that way back into the parking lot here at Memorial Field.
for two.
So a huge inning for the Hurricanes. Hard to keep up with everything. But
in the second, the Hurricanes scored four runs on three hits. There was one Acadia error and one runner left on base. Through two complete, Holland College 6, Acadia 1.
So it's 6-1 as we head to the top of the third now. So strikeout on Kyle Donahue to end the second inning. And Logan Gland had that single, two RBIs. Taylor Larkin scored. J.J. Orem scored. Dominic Ryan scored. And Jonathan Arsenault scored, all for the Hurricanes in the four-run second inning. And we'll head to the third inning now in this 6-1 baseball game for the Hurricanes. Spencer Horn returns to the mound. He has four strikeouts so far. Two hits given up and one run on the Axemen. Crazy bottom of the second for the Hurricanes there. First pitch of the inning by Horn is fouled over the fence here at Memorial Field. Horn way outside, catcher can't get it. Six-one ball game here in the top of the third. Spencer Horn throws that one in for strike one. Strike two, I'm sorry. 1-2 the count. As the leadoff hitter, Matt Gendron, left fielder for the Axemen, is at the plate to start the third inning for Horn. And the Hurricanes, another foul into the dirt. Horn has four strikeouts so far this game. He's given up two hits and one run. Ooh, close. But a ball. 2-2 now would be the count. Leadoff hitter Matt Gendron, the left fielder. In for the Axemen. Ooh, down in the dirt at the feet of Gendron. Full count to start off this third inning after a crazy bottom of the second for the Hurricanes as Jonathan Arsenault, Dominic Ryan, Jay Orem, and Taylor Larkin all score for the Hurricanes and make it 6-1. Fouled off here by Gendron into the trees. Behind the Axemen dugout. Game one of a doubleheader. At Memorial Field, the wild card series. And he'll walk Gendron to start the third inning as the Axemen will look to get some offense rolling. Cut the 6-1 lead down. Here in the third inning, in seven innings of baseball. Best of three series between the Axemen and the Hurricanes. If the Hurricanes win, they will advance to the Nationals in UNB. That begin this coming Thursday. That one's hit way in the air. Jay Orem will move for the left fielder. Brett Hicken, who dives in. Out number one on the inning.
Second baseman number nine.
Hit over the head of Jay Orem, who gave way to Hicken. Now, and that's out number one on Mark Matthias, the first baseman. Ted Heige, the second baseman, comes to the plate. One away. A man on first. Again drawn. You're in the top of the third inning. 6-1 baseball game. Ooh, down in the dirt inside. Ball one for Ted Heige, who's 0-for-1 on the day, the second baseman. Batting in the number three position. His horn will send it to first, where our Gendron is. He'll slide in. Get his fingers to first base. 1-0. An out on Mark Matthias as he flew out into left field. The runner goes, but it's in the dirt, and Logan Gallant can't control it. So Gendron will reach second. Stolen base for Gendron. Here's Ted Heige. He's at the plate with one away. X-Men need some offense here in the third. That one will be rolled grounder to Jay Orem, who bounces off his glove. And that'll be a single for Ted Heige. Gendron will reach third. Runners on the corner with one away for the Axemen. As catcher Mark McPhee comes to the plate for the Axemen. He walked to lead off the second inning for the Axemen. Eventually scored the only run for the Axemen so far today. One away for Horn. Runners on the corner after a single by Ted Heige. Bounced off the glove of Jay Orem. A grounder to the shortstop. Strike one to start on McPhee. If you are watching today through the live stream, send a tweet to Canes M Baseball on Twitter. That's at Canes M Baseball. As the Hurricanes look for a double play, they won't get it. They will get the lead runner at second as Jay Orem scoops that up and sends it to Jonathan Arsenal, the second baseman. Jonathan sends it to Kyle Donahoe, but the runner,
third baseman,
Mark McPhee, he's on time. Out at second. Ted Heige. They will score. And it's now a 6-2 baseball game. And the Axemen. So 6-2. As Gendron scores for the Axemen. Runner on first now with two away. Mark McPhee with that RBI single. The Hurricanes able to get Heige at second. Will Robinson had a hit in the second inning. And Spencer Horn will look for out number three. To end this top of the third inning. Now a 6-2 baseball game. Axemen able to score a run here in the third. Looking for more. Will Robinson will have to extend the inning for that to happen. He'll hit that hard into left field, where Brett Hicken is, and he'll end the third inning as he gets under that ball. For Spencer Horn and the Hurricanes.
In the top of the third, the Axemen scored one run on one hit. There were no Hurricane errors and one runner left on base. Heading to the bottom of third, 6-2 Holland College.
Now we'll go back to the Hurricanes. Dylan McQuaid, the third baseman, will lead off this third inning. Brett Hicken and Jonathan Arsenault, the 7-8 batters, due up as well in a 6-2 baseball game. Bottom of the third, CCBA baseball from Memorial Field in Charlottetown in this wild card series. David Pilott returns to the mound for his third inning. He's given up 6 runs on 6 hits. Sorry, 5 hits. It's a 6-2 baseball game. Dylan McQuay with a flyout in the first. He's 0-for-1 in the game.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to pick up your 50-50 ticket by visiting the canteen in left field. The draw will take place in the 6th inning of today's 2nd game. Good luck.
Pilott gets ready for this third inning. Mark McPhee, the catcher, just turns behind the plate for the Axemen. Dylan McQuay due up for the Hurricanes now to start off this third. Bottom of the third.
Leading off the bottom of the third inning for the Hurricanes, third baseman number 32, Dylan McQuay.
Six-two baseball game, game one of two for the day. Dylan McQuaid will hit that way in the air. Did the same thing in the second inning. And the second baseman for the Axemen, number 9, Ted Heiga, will get under that.
Number 10, Brett Hicken.
Out number one for the Axemen here in the third inning. Brett Hicken, the left fielder, 0-for-1 on the day, comes to the plate. One away here in the third. First pitch out for Pilott and the Axemen. Number 7 batter for the Hurricanes, Brett Hicken, fouls that along the third base, first baseline. 0-1 is the count, one away. Another strike. It catches that inside. And it's 0-2. One away on Brett Hicken. Outside. 1-2. Hicken watches that go by. That one will be high and outside as well. 2-2 the count now as Hicken battles back. Another foul ball as it's hit in the dirt by Hicken. Two and two, one away. David Pilott. It's a 6-2 baseball game. In game one of the best of three between the Axemen and the Hurricanes. Games 1 and 2 here in Charlottetown. If we need game 3, it will be at Acadia tomorrow. Full count for Hicken as he watches that. A go by. Call ball. Bottom of the third. Pitch. Hicken will hit that one to the first baseman who controls it and will tag first. Two away now for the Axemen, as Jonathan Arsenault will come up with 2 outs, no runners on.
Second baseman number 25, Jonathan Arsenault.
Arsenal was walked in the second inning, eventually scored the third run of the game for the Hurricanes in the second inning, which opened this game up. The first of four runs in the second for the Hurricanes. Pull out with the pitch to Arsenal. That one will be high inside. Ball one. Arsenal hits that hard and foul on the third base. It hits the pole holding the lights for Memorial Field here. Bounces towards the field. Foul one and one. The count two away for Arsenal. That'll be a high. 2-1 the count now. On Jonathan Arsenal, two-way, third inning baseball here. Fouled just over the head of the catcher into the fence behind home plate here at Memorial Field. Dominic Ryan, number nine hitter for the Hurricanes on deck. He's 1-for-1 and scored in the second inning. Hoping Jonathan will reach, and he might, as the left fielder will catch that one along the third base line. Hit hard. The third baseman for the Axemen, Will Robinson, able to get there and get the third out of the inning for Pilat and the Axemen. Three up, three down for Pilat. We go to the top of the fourth now. Spencer Horn returns to the mound for his fourth inning. For the Hurricanes, due up for the Axemen, shortstop Tristan Reed, right fielder Sam Gallant, and designated hitter Percy Clark here in the fourth inning. It's a 6-2 baseball game for Horn and the Hurricanes. Horn through three innings, giving up three hits, two runs. He has four strikeouts on the mound. We have Tristan Reed coming to the plate, number 13, the shortstop.
Leading off the fourth inning for the Axemen, shortstop number 13, Tristan Reed.
Spencer Horn starting the fourth inning now. That will be a ball one for Reed, as the Axemen will look to get something going. Offensive. And that one will be hit way in the air. And the center fielder should get under that one. As Taylor Larkin, one away. Fly out from Tristan Reed.
Right fielder number 16, Sam Gallant.
And it's one away. First batter for the Axemen. One away here in the fourth inning. Spencer Horn on Sam Gallant.
How was the service call?
For the Axemen, the right fielder. 0 for 1. He was struck out in the second inning. Oh, that one's inside, ball one.
That's my mistake. I set you up by accident. Should have warned you. Well, out of there, since 10 o'clock. Back room of the jewelry store. Shut off my wall. Light with modems.
Sam Gallant standing in for the Axemen. Strike. 2-2 the count now. Sam Gallant argues that one with the umpire. One away in this 6-2 baseball game for the Hurricanes. Foul ball by Gallant. Foul ball for Gallant. He stays alive. 2-2 the count. One away for Horn. And the Hurricanes here in the top of the fourth inning. Ooh. And that one. Will be a ball. On Gallant for a full count now, I think. Or it might have been a foul ball. I think it hit the batter, but I think it's going to be 2-2 the count, as it was called a foul ball by the home plate umpire. Ooh, ball three to full count now. That one was close, and the Hurricanes dugout does not agree. Full count, though, one away for Sam Gallant and the Axemen. And that'll be a strikeout as Sam Gallant heads towards first, thinking he got the walk. Not so. Spencer Horn, two away. Strikeout number five for him here in the fourth inning. Two away for the Hurricanes.
The designated hitter, Percy Clark.
Now Percy Clark will come to the plate. The designated hitter for the Axemen, Owen. 0-for-1, he was struck out in the second inning. He hits that one foul into the trees at Memorial Field. Two away. We're looking to end the inning. That's ball one for Clark. Two away, no runners on. Sam Gallant strikes out for the second out of the inning. Strike number two, 1-2 the count now for Horn on Clark. Oh! Close to the head of Clark. 2-2 now the count. Two away. The pitch from Horn. Hit right back to the pitcher, Horn, who will grab that and throw it to first, Kyle Donahoe. And out number three. Perfectly played by Horn as it ends up back into his glove. And now we head to the bottom of the fourth with Dominic Ryan, the number nine hitter for the Hurricanes, due up.
Did they have any hits or anything?
That inning, it was three up, three down for the Axemen. Top of the fourth, we're headed to the bottom of the fourth now.
The Axemen in the top of the fourth, they had no runs and no hits. There were no Hurricane errors and none left on base.
The number nine hitter, Dominic Ryan, due up. He is 1-for-1 and he scored in the second, the fourth run for the Hurricanes. As David Palat returns to the mound for the fourth inning. In a 6-2 baseball game for the Hurricanes. A beautiful day here at Memorial Field, Victoria Park, for this wild card series in the CCBA playoffs. Hurricanes win the series. They'll head to the Nationals next weekend. At UNB Fredericton. First game of the tournament takes place on Thursday, October 22nd, 12 p.m. Against the Atlantic Conference champions. That's if the Hurricanes can win this series and make it to the Nationals. Dominic Ryan comes to the plate, the right fielder for the Hurricanes. If the Axemen win this series, they'll have to play Concordia in Montreal and try and win their berth to the Nationals. Here in Charlottetown for bottom of the fourth, and Dominic Ryan. And it's 1-1 the count as he leads off this bottom of the inning. And David Pilott and the Axemen down 6-2. Strike two, 1-2 the count now. The Hurricanes were eliminated from the playoffs by the St. Mary's Huskies in game three of the three-game series just this past week as they split the first two here in Charlottetown, and the Hurricanes traveled to Halifax to take on the Huskies. Dominic Ryan, 2-1 the count. That one's inside, 3-1 now the count for Ryan. On David Plott and the Axemen. 3-2 the count. Full count. That'll be strikeout number one for Plott in the game. And out number one here in the bottom of the fourth. As we'll go to the top of the order for the Hurricanes. Now Jay Orem comes to the plate. One away. Bottom of the fourth. 6-2 baseball game. Orem. 0-1. Get a single in the second. That'll get hit to the first baseman right to him. He'll control that touch first. Mark Matthias, the first baseman for the Axemen, get out number two here in the fourth. On leadoff hitter, J.J. Orem, the shortstop. Taylor Larkin, due up next for the Hurricanes, the center fielder.
Now batting for the Hurricanes, the center fielder, number 16, Taylor Larkin.
Larkin walked in the second and scored for the Hurricanes. He had a ground out in the first. And he'll bunt. Pitcher Pilott will reach that, get it there to the first baseman in time, the umpire says at first. Keeps his foot on the bag, and out number three, and the first base coach for the Hurricanes will argue that one is he thought the first baseman's Mark Matthias's foot came off the bag as he reached for that one, the throw from pitcher Pilott.
They had no runs and no hits. There were no errors and none left on base. After four complete, Holland Hurricanes 6 and Acadia University Axemen 2.
So now we'll head to the top of the fifth inning. Hurricanes get nothing done in the bottom of the fourth. They do hold a 6-2 lead through four innings. And now we head to the fifth inning. Spencer Horn back on the mound for the Hurricanes. And the number nine hitter, Wes Harding, center fielder, is due up for the Axemen. Three up, three down for David Pilott and the Axemen. As the Hurricanes head coach Andrew McNevin talks to home plate umpire. I don't think they like the call at first to end the fourth inning on Taylor Larkin. So Spencer Horn has five strikeouts so far today as he looks to start the fifth inning. Now the number nine hitter in for the Axemen to start the fifth inning. The Axemen need to get some runs and get their offense going as they're down by four runs to the Hurricanes. And the game is now in its fifth inning of seven-inning baseball. Harding will look for the bunt. It'll get by. Strike number one on Harding to start this fifth inning. Down in the dirt, Horn. 1-1 the count to start the fifth. Harding was struck out in the second. This is his second at-bat of the day. He's the center fielder for the Axemen. That'll get to the third baseman through the glove of the third baseman, past the shortstop, Orem, and into the left field, where Brett Hicken will just control it and send it into Jonathan Arsenault. So a single, leadoff single for Wes Harding, the number nine hitter for the Axemen. Man on first. No outs. That one bounced off the glove of Dylan McQuaid, the third baseman for the Hurricanes. Continue to roll past the shortstop, Jay Orem, into left field. Ooh, as Wes Harding looked to go, decided not to. Stays at first. And now back to the top of the order for the Axemen. This is number seven, Matt Gendron, the left fielder. 0-1 on the day. He was struck out in the first and walked in the third. Now Gendron will get the call from the third base coach of the Axemen. Come to the plate, man on first. No outs. Spencer Horn on the mound for the Hurricanes in this fifth inning. And there goes Harding. The throw should be on time to Jonathan Arsenault. Man out at second. First out of the inning. A great play by Logan Gallant, the catcher of the Hurricanes, right into the glove of second baseman Jonathan Arsenault. He tries to steal second. Not happening with Logan Gallant and Jonathan Arsenault. A great defensive play for the first out of the inning. Now no runners stand on base. One away as Gendron fouls that. No. Gendron still at the plate. He battles it out with Spencer Horn. It's 1-2 the count. One away now after the Hurricanes caught Wes Harding stealing second for the first out of the inning. Fifth inning baseball here from Memorial Field. Going to check up on the swing, but they say he didn't go. 2-2 now the count on Gendron. Ball three, full count now on for Gendron with one out. As he battles back against Horn. That'll be strikeout number six on the day for Spencer Horn. Gendron watches that one fly by. Out number two in the fifth. Mark Matthias, the first baseman, 0-2 on the day. To the plate for the Axemen. He'll send that right back to the pitcher into second baseman Jonathan Arsenault. Out number three. A great play by Jonathan Arsenault as it rolled by the feet of Spencer Horn past the second base. Jonathan Arsenault ends the inning. As Mark Matthias out. So we head to the bottom of the fifth inning now. This is still a 6-2 baseball game. No out, no run scored since the third inning. Where the Hurricanes scored. Sorry, the Axemen scored their second run. Hurricanes exploded in the second for four runs. They had two in the first. And that's how we're at this 6-2 baseball game. As David Palat, pitcher for the Axemen, returns to the mound for his fifth inning. Due up for the Hurricanes is the designated hitter, Grant Grady, catcher, Logan Gallant, and the first baseman, Kyle Donahoe. Here in the bottom of the fifth for the Hurricanes. Great day for baseball here as we head to the bottom of the fifth.
Grant Grady.
Comes to the plate for the Hurricanes starting off this bottom of the fifth. Hurricanes hold a 6-2 lead here in game one of two for the day. Best of three series between the Axemen and the Hurricanes. He'll send that right back to the pitcher, David Palat, who will pitch it to first, out number one on the first pitch. Grant Grady 0-for-3 on the day. And he's out number one here in the bottom of the fifth as Logan Gallant comes to the plate.
Now batting for the Hurricanes, the catcher, number 5, Logan Gallant.
So I stand corrected. If Acadia wins this series, they only go to Nationals if Montreal beats Concordia. And then Acadia would win the wild card and play the Atlantic champion on Thursday at noon to start the Nationals. But if the Hurricanes win, they for sure go to the Nationals. As Logan Gallant hits that to the shortstop, who sends it to first. First baseman Mark Matthias out number two on Logan Gallant.
So, number 9, Kyle Donahoe.
All comes down to if the Hurricanes win this series, they're guaranteed to go to the Nationals. If Acadia wins, it will be either Acadia or Concordia. So everything's still up in the air to see who will be the teams that go to the Nationals this weekend. Next weekend, I should say, in Fredericton at UNB. Kyle Donahoe sends that along the third baseline. Third baseman sends that to first. It's in time. Foot on the base. Three up, three down for David Palat and the Axemen. And we'll go to the top of the sixth inning. So a good inning for the Axemen defense and Palat as they go up three up, three down. And now here in the sixth inning, they'll have to get some offense as they're down by four in the top of the sixth inning. Spencer Horn returns to the mound for the Hurricanes. Hurricanes want to go back to Nationals. They were there last year. It was in Montreal. This year it is a little closer to home at UNB in Fredericton. It's all up to this series. Acadia will have to win the series and then get some luck. On the other end is Montreal and Concordia. Are in the middle of a series this weekend as well. Ted Higa will come to start the sixth for the Axemen.
Six for the Axemen. Second baseman,
Tadaga 1-for-2 on the day with a single in the third inning. He starts off this sixth inning for the Axemen. Look to get the bats going and shorten this lead that the Hurricanes have. Ted Heiga, the second baseman for the Axemen. Fouled by Heiga. So determine that who goes to the Nationals. They determine whoever has the best regular season record from the wins the wild card. So if the Hurricanes win this wild card, they will have the best record and go to the Nationals. But if the Axemen win, it'll come down to Concordia and Montreal. The Hurricanes were undefeated in the regular season, then lost two to St. Mary's as that one's fouled. It sounded like it may have hit a car in the parking lot here at Memorial Field.
Two girls playing ball with in the tournament this weekend. I want to see what their shirts say.
Nice crowd here at Memorial Field. It's a nice fall day for baseball. It's Ted Heiga with a long at-bat to start the sixth. He desperately wants to reach here to start the sixth for the Axemen. It's a full count on Heiga with no outs. Spencer Horn, Logan Glant. We'll discuss catcher Mark McPhee on deck for the Axemen. Pitch from Horn and full count. No outs. Hit by Heiga into left field. Three of them running for it. None of them will reach it. Brett Hicken sends it to the second baseman. It gets away from Jonathan Arsenault, and Heiga will be in on second to lead off the sixth inning. It dropped in between the shortstop, Jay Oram, and the left fielder, Brett Hicken. Hicken then sends it to Jonathan Arsenault, the second baseman. But it got away from him, and Heiga will reach. He stands at second. No outs is catcher Mark McPhee, who's 1-for-1 on the day. He had a walk in the second and a single in the third. Ball one. No outs. Heiga standing at second base. All two, 2-0 to start. No outs for Horn. Foul ball over our heads here in the booth. 2-1 the count now for Mark McPhee, the catcher. For the Axemen, he's having a good day. He's in an RBI single, and he scored after being walked in the second. That one's hit foul two. Big hitter here. Mark McPhee sends that way into the trees. And foul. Another foul ball. That hits Logan Gallant in the leg or the midsection. He's down. Jason Monahan will come and attend to him. That one was fouled hard back to Logan Gallant. Looks like it hit him in the knee. Now we'll have Andrew McNevin and Jason Monahan tend to Logan Gallant here in the sixth inning as he takes that foul ball hard into the leg. That's got to hurt. Mark McPhee is a big hitter here. And he hit that one hard. Looks like Logan Gallant will walk this one off and should be okay to continue here in the top of the sixth inning for this Hurricane team. It's a 2-2 count on Mark McPhee. And no outs. There's a man on second, Ted Heiga. Reached on a double to lead off the second inning, or sixth inning, sorry. 6-2 baseball game. That one's hit way foul. As Colin Arsenault begins to warm up for the Hurricanes along the third baseline. And the Hurricanes bullpen. Spencer Horn is a man on second, no outs here, and into his sixth inning of baseball. 2-2 the count, no outs. That one is just a little inside, says the home plate umpire. 3-2 full count. As the Axemen need some offense here in the sixth. A man on second, another man on would be huge, and they have life here in the sixth inning as Mark McPhee will be walked after a long at-bat with Spencer Horn. Runners on first and second, no out. His second walk of the day off Spencer Horn. That's for Mark McPhee. Coach will visit the mound, talk to Spencer Horn and Logan Gallant as there's runners on first and second, no outs for the Axemen here in the sixth inning. See how Horn feels in this sixth inning of baseball. Horn will continue to pitch for the Hurricanes here. As Will Robinson, the third baseman, 1-for-2 on the day, with a hit in the second and a flyout in the third. He'll come to bat with no outs, runners on first and second. This heart of the Axemen lineup, batters 3, 4, 5. Look to get the offense going for the Axemen here in the sixth inning. It'll be strike one to start on Robinson, the third baseman. As Colin Arsenault continues to warm up along the third baseline for the Hurricanes, just in case they need him. Strike two on Robinson. 0-2, no outs. Be a huge out. Would be a huge out for the Hurricanes and Spencer Horn. Runners on first and second, Ted Heiga and Mark McPhee. Strikeout number 7 on the day for Spencer Horn. And that'll retire Will Robinson here in the sixth inning. Out number 1 is Tristan Reed, the shortstop. Comes to the plate. 1-for-2 on the day. He had a flyout in the fourth, a single, RBI single in the second. One away here in the sixth inning for Spencer Horn. Runner still on first and second. Swing for strike one. Top of the sixth. Seven-inning baseball in the CCBA wildcard series. He'll foul that back. Tristan Reed will. Going to the count. And he'll try and catch Ted Heige at second, but they will not. Heige and McPhee on base, first and second. One away. Spencer Horn steps off again. Thought about throwing to second, but no one in position, and he'll focus back on Tristan Reed, the shortstop, at the plate. He'll hit that through the pitcher to Jonathan Arsenault. Looks to get the advance, the lead runner. He does. He will get Mark McPhee at second for out number two. But whoa, Tristan Reed will reach. So one out after Mark McPhee. Mark McPhee called out at second as they get that runner. But Heige will advance to third with two away. And now Andrew McNevin will come to the mound. Take the ball from Spencer Horn after 5 2/3 baseball and a 6-2 lead. Seven strikeouts for Horn on the day. And a good outing to get this Hurricanes team up 6-2. Now Colin Arsenault will come in to look to end the sixth. Number 57, Colin Arsenault for the Hurricanes in.
Now pitching for the Hurricanes, number 57, Colin Arsenault.
Two away here in the sixth for the Hurricanes. The Axemen have runners on the corners, first and third. Ted Heige at third and Tristan Reed on first. Now Sam Gallant, the right fielder, who's 0 for 2 with two strikeouts in the game, comes to the plate. He'll face Colin Arsenault this time. Game one of two today. Stick around. Game two will take place around between 3 and 3:30. Should start. See, it's 3 now, so I would say probably closer to 3:30. As we're only in the sixth inning of seven-inning baseball. Game one of the series. Best of three series between the Hurricanes and the Axemen. Sam Gallant, the right fielder, to the plate against Colin Arsenault. Two away for the Hurricanes. Runners on first and third. Ted Heige and Tristan Reed. Axemen looking to cut this lead down. Colin Arsenault checks up. They're going home. And that one will be high and not in time. 6-3 runner advances to second now. And they'll check up there. He should reach. So Tristan Reed will reach second as Logan Gallant argues with home plate umpire. on that run. And now Andrew McNevin, the coach of the Hurricanes team, will discuss with the home plate umpire. Logan Glenn was sure he tagged him in time as he reached home. So a run for Ted Heiga makes it 6-3 now, here with two away in the sixth inning. Colin Arsenault just into the game. Six-three baseball. Axeman looking to get some momentum. That one will be hit over the shortstop J.J. Orm's head. No, it'll be right into the glove of the shortstop J.J. Orm. And it's 6-3. Two hits in the sixth inning and one run for the Axemen.
In the top of the sixth, they scored one run on two hits. There were no errors and two left on base.
So it's now 6-3 as we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. The X-Men able to get one run against now Colin Arsenault and the Hurricanes. And we'll head to the sixth inning. Bottom of the sixth inning. 3-run lead for the Hurricanes, 6-3. As David Plott will return to the mound for his sixth inning of baseball. Due up for the Hurricanes, be Dylan McQuaid, Brett Hicken, and Jonathan Arsenault. 6-7-8 batters for the Hurricanes. Now Dylan McQuaid comes to the plate for the Hurricanes, 0-2 on the day. He'll start off the bottom of the sixth, looking to get something going for the Hurricanes. They're up by 3 here in the sixth. David Plott back to the mound for his sixth inning of baseball. Inside, pitch number 1, ball 1. Hit high, but it should be foul and out of play on top of the Axemen dugout. It hits the roof. One now, starting this bottom of the sixth inning. Ball 2. 2-1 the count now. This game 1 winds down here. We have another game next. Dylan McQuaid sends that to the third baseman. He grabs that, throws it to first. Out number 1 in the inning. That'll be Robinson finding first baseman Mark Matthias. And Dylan McQuaid will be the first out of this sixth inning. Now Brett Hicken, the left fielder for the Hurricanes, 0-2 on the day. Strike 1. Start the count on Hicken. Foul ball. 0-2 the count now. One away for Palat and the Axemen. One's a little high, 2-1-2 now the count on Brett Hicken. One away. One of the sixth inning. 6-3 the score as the Axemen score one in the top of the sixth. That one's sent foul over our heads into the parking lot here at Memorial Field. As baseball season winds down here in Hurricanes, and this CCBA league will finish up next weekend at Nationals. As Brett Hicken sends that into left field, or center field, sorry, and the center fielder, Wes Harding, will be right there for the out. Two away now.
Batting for the Hurricanes. Second base, number 25,
Jonathan Arsenault now. Walked in the second and ended up scoring. He was out in the third. David Palat has had a good day other than the first two innings where he gave up the six runs. He's gone three up, three down in the third, the fourth, the fifth, and now he's got two sixth. So he's had a good day. He had to struggle to start the game in the first and second, giving up those six runs against the Hurricanes, which has killed the Axemen up till now. And that one will be a ball, so 1-1 count, two way. Jonathan Arsenault at the plate for the Hurricanes. Ball two, 2-1 the count now. David Palat will look to go three up, three down. But Jonathan Arsenault looks to extend the inning. Two way, he sends that past the pitcher, and it will be a single for Jonathan Arsenault as he finds an open space past the pitcher, past the second baseman into center field. And a grounder will help Jonathan reach two out single for Jonathan Arsenault. Bottom of the sixth, Dominic Ryan, the number nine right fielder, number nine hitter, the right fielder. One for two in the day, singled and scored in the second, strikeout in the fourth against Palat. Two outs here in the sixth inning. Number nine hitter, Dominic Ryan. Ball one. Start the count. Jonathan Arsenault heads to second, but it's fouled by Ryan. He'll return to first. As he fouled that off the mask of the car. Two outs here for David Palat, looking to end this sixth inning. We'll head to the seventh. Strike two on Ryan, 1-2 the count. Bottom of the sixth. We'll go to the seventh after this, and Colin Arsenault will look to end the game and win this first game of this three-game series for the Hurricanes. Dominic Ryan hits that hard into left field. The left fielder scaling back, and he gets the third out of the inning. Matt Gendron reeling backwards, able to find it in the sun. Fly for Dominic Ryan. And now we head to the seventh inning, where the number 8 and 9 batters, Percy Clark, the hitter, Wes Harding, the center fielder, are due up. And then we're headed to the top of the order, where Matt Gendron, the left fielder, due up. And the Hurricanes will look to end this game in game number one. Top of the seven. 6-3. Lots of baseball left today. We'll have another game following this CCBA wild card series. If the Hurricanes win this series, they will head to the Nationals next weekend in Fredericton. If they can end the series today, it goes to Acadia tomorrow for game three. If the Hurricanes win the series, they're in the Nationals. If Acadia wins the series, it'll come down to the outcome of the Concordia-Montreal series to see if Acadia will go to the Nationals in that wildcard position. So a lot to be decided here in the next 2 days of baseball action for the Nationals. Start next Thursday at noon in Fredericton. Where the Atlantic champion will take on the wildcard. Now due up Percy Clark, the designated hitter for the Axemen here, to start the top of the seventh against Colin Arsenault, who came in relief in the sixth inning from Spencer Horn, who went 6 2/3, had 7 strikeouts and allowed 2 runs. In comes Clark. Clark is 0-2 on the day. He struck out in the second. He's yet to face Colin Arsenault, who's still fresh in this game. In at the end of the sixth for one out. As he'll swing at the first pitch, Percy Clark to shortstop, Orem to first. Dono can't catch that leadoff. He'll reach on a... couldn't find that ball, and now up is the number 9 hitter, Wes Harding, the center fielder, number 18. So Donahoe should have been in one away, but Percy Clark reaches. And now first pitch hit for Wes Harding, and that should be an out as left fielder Brett Hicken. We'll get onto that one. Runner remains at first. Wes Harding. Now we'll go to the top of the lineup for the Axemen. Matt Gendron, the left fielder. Number 7. Gendron has struck out twice in this game so far to Spencer Horn, and he walked and scored in the third. Man on first, one away. Percy Clark, the designated hitter on first. Strike one on Gendron for Colin Arsenault. If we do go to the bottom of the seventh, it'll be the top of the order for the Hurricanes. Larkin and Grant Grady. Colin Arsenault with a 3-run cushion here to end this one and win game one of the 3-game best of 3 series for the wild card. For the third place in the Atlantic is what this is for. And then it depends on Montreal and Concordia series. Who will win the wild card berth into the Nationals. If the Hurricanes win this series, they will for sure head to UNB next weekend. Ball one. Nationals next weekend at Fredericton will take place at Royals Field as they will get one and the pitch will get away from Donahoe. They get the lead runner at second. They'll get Percy Clark out at second, but Matt Gendron will reach on a single. And there's two away, one man on, and Colin Arsenault and Hurricanes one out away from ending this first game today. now in is Mark Matthias, the first baseman, who's 0 for 3 on the day. In his hands, man on first, two outs, seventh inning. Colin Arsenault, he'll swing first pitch, and that should get in, and it does, right in front of Brad Hicken. Man will reach second, Mark Matthias, with a single to extend the inning and extend this baseball game. For the time being, now as we'll head to the number three hitter, Ted Higa, number nine.
Second baseman, Ted Higa.
He bats in the number three position, and he's 2 for 3 with a single in the third and a double in the sixth. Runners on first and second, now two away. Colin Arsenault can end this ball game. Strike one for Arsenault. The Nationals next weekend will be broadcasted over this Bell live stream. You can catch all the action. That'll be hit into the infield. It should be foul, but Logan Glantz should get under and end this baseball game. And the Hurricanes win game one of the best of three. And a doubleheader today, and they take this one 7-3 over the Acadia Axemen. And they'll look to finish the series here today at Memorial Field. The game will be shortly here at Memorial Field. Another high. There should be first pitch for game two. 1-0 series lead for the Hurricanes as Colin Arsenault ends the seventh inning. Spencer Horn will get the win on the mound. 1-0 series. Stick around for more CCBA action here from Memorial Field in Charlottetown. I'm Darcy Cudmore. The Hurricanes win game one, 6-3.